Here's what we're going to do. We're going to check out Matthew 6, and it's verses, we're going to start with verses 5 through 8, because this is where Jesus is talking about prayer. And Todd told me that you guys are going through the Sermon on the Mount right now. Is that right? Kind of going through Matthew 5 through 7, is that right?
Sure.
Yeah? Okay. This is part of the Sermon on the Mount, and Jesus is about to teach us how to pray, but before he teaches us how to pray, he tells us to do two things, all right? First thing he tells us to do is to get alone, get by yourself. The second thing he does, it tells us not to babble. Let's read this first part. It says, when you pray, don't be like the hypocrites. Now, who is Jesus probably talking about right here? The Pharisees. Has Todd been talking to you guys about the Pharisees? Okay. They're the people who are very religious back in Jesus' time. They're the ones that really seemed like they were good people and that they were the ones that were following after God. They were very religious. But check out what they used to do. For they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on street corners to be seen by men. They wanted every single person in the city to look down on them and say, oh, aren't they so holy? Don't they love God so much? Look how good they are. They pray. And you know what else they used to do to get everyone's attention? Whenever they would bring out their tithe or their offering, you know what they would do? They would hire people to play horns and trumpets. And they would line these trumpet players up, and they would start this, and they would walk down to the temple, and they would give their offering. And they made that noise so everyone would come out of their houses and look down and be like, oh, that Pharisee is giving his money again. Oh, that Pharisee, he's praying on the street corner so everyone will see him. Isn't he so good? Isn't he so holy? That's where the term tooting your own horn actually comes from. I don't know if you guys know that. When you brag about yourself, when you draw attention to yourself, you're tooting your own horn. It comes from the Pharisees. Because they used to do this. They used to stand on street corners. But this is what Jesus says about them. I tell you the truth, they've received their reward in full. And so this is what he tells us before we even start to pray. He's going to teach us how to pray, but before he teaches us, he's going to tell us to do this. But when you pray, go into your room and close the door and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will what? Reward you. Your Father who sees what's done in secret will reward you. So before he teaches us how to pray, he tells us to do two things. The first one is get by yourself. Get alone. Spend some intentional time with God without trying to impress anybody else. All right? Second thing comes in this next verse. It says, and when you pray, don't keep babbling like pagans, for they think that they will be heard because of their many words. Don't be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask him. In other words, this, don't babble. Don't just talk. Don't just say memorized scripted prayers that don't mean anything, and you're not trying to connect to God in any way, but all you're trying to do is go through the motions of a prayer, and it's a very religious thing. Jesus says, don't do this. Don't babble. Don't talk with your eyes closed. There is a difference. There's a huge difference. So what do you do? Get alone and don't babble. Those are two things you need to know before you even start to pray. All